apartment, third floor. Hey, are you alone?
No, I got someone in the elevator.
Third floor.
Let me out! Hey, wait a minute. Somebody broke my train. Hey!
Little man, what have we here?
I got two trains for Christmas. My mom bought me one train, my friend bought me that one. So please, can I have the money to give back to him?
This train is broken, Sonny.
It's just a little broke. It got broken in the elevator just now. But I didn't do it, honest.
Where's your mother?
My mother?
Yes, you're not here all alone, are you?
No, she's here.
Where?
She's in the bathroom.
Imagine her nerve. So I said, madam, you go out and see Mr. Crowley. He owns the store. Show him your broken lamp and he'll be glad to give you your money back. He does it all the time.
I'll bet you told her that.
Where's Mr. Crowley's office?
8th floor, Sonny.
Where's
Mr. Crowley's
office?
Secretary behind the petition. I see. Yes. I'm very sorry, but Mr. Crowley can't be disturbed at this time. You might try tomorrow morning.
Well, hello. What is it, son?
I gotta see Mr. Crowley. Please let me.
Mr. Crowley? Are you alone?
Yes, ma'am.
What's your name?
Timothy Ennis.
Mr. Timothy Ennis, what seems to be the trouble?
I got two trains for Christmas. So please, will Mr. Crowley give me my money back? Please?
Well, I don't know.
He's the only man who can help me. So please, can I see him?
Well, you come along with me and we'll see what we can do. Now sit right here, Timmy. Don't run away. And I think I can get Mr. Crowley to see you.
You won't call my mother or a policeman, will you?
No, I won't call your mother or a policeman.
Okay, thank you.
Emily, this is the meditation hour.
I'm awfully sorry to disturb you, Mr. Crowley. But one of our customers, Mr. Ennis, is outside asking to see you.
You know I don't see the customers.
I think you'll want to see this one.
Why?
Because Mr. Ennis is roughly 6 years old.
6 years old?
And seems to be in an awful lot of trouble. Well,
is he here all alone?
He's the aloneest little fellow I ever saw.
Emily, don't keep the customer waiting. Service, Timothy. Won't you come a little closer? I see you have our Red Rocket Express. I hope it hasn't proved unsatisfactory.
I've got two trains for Christmas. My mom bought me one train. My friend bought me this one. So please, can I have the money back?
Well, Timothy, this is a little unusual. We'll have to look into it.
It got broken in the elevator. They didn't do it, honest.
I see. So you've got two trains for Christmas.
No, I'll tell you the truth. I only got this one train for Christmas. Steve got it for me. He's my friend. And he's real poor. And he hasn't got a job. And he shouldn't have spent his money, and I want to give it back to him. And the lady said that you could help me.
No. Here, take it easy. It isn't going to be as bad as that. Now, come on, stop crying. Here, now. Now, Timmy, suppose you tell me this story from the beginning.
Well, it all started with my mother. Her name is Mrs. Dennis. And she works for Fisher and Lewis. She's a comparison shopper. And she bought...
Oh, just a minute.